make way for Paul Daugherty, the columnist for the Cincinnati Inquirer. What's the biggest problem with the Bengals, Paul?
How much time? Wow, you put that one right on a tee for me, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Well, here's the stat that I read that I thought was outstanding. Listen to this. They're the first NFL team to play their first two games at home and fail to score a touchdown since 1939. I didn't even know there was an NFL. Was there an NFL 1939?
Well, at least they're setting records. We didn't say what kind of records, Paul, but the Bengals are setting records.
Making names for themselves, as we say.
Okay. Do you do anything drastic here if you're Marvin Lewis?
What are you going to do? I mean, sure. Why not? I mean, they're 0-2. They play at Lambeau a week from Sunday. They're going to be 0-3. I don't know what the number is for teams that go 0-3 and make the playoffs, but it ain't great. And this team won't be one of them. So he doesn't have a contract for next year. The first time that Mike Brown and he could not agree on an extension prior to the coming year. Sure. A.J. McCarron should be the quarterback. For one, why not?
Well, this is
point. Why not?
I think what happens sometimes when teams get down on themselves, that seems to be this malaise, this dark cloud. Sometimes you need to do something just to spark them. And I don't know if putting A.J. McCarron in there sparks them, because I can't put the blame on Andy Dalton. It's not on Andy Dalton as much as it is, it's a team. Does A.J. Green get the ball enough? Mixon and his role here? They've got star power here, Paul. Why
yes,
is it that
that
people view them as, a playoff team on the periphery here? Why is that?
The line's not very good, although they did an okay job last night. Baltimore blew them up in the first game when they got shut out. But they weren't great last night, but they did protect Dalton most of the time. He had a pocket most of the time. He just missed on key throws. I mean, second week in a row, he missed a wide-open guy deep. In the fourth quarter, he managed to get the ball to A.J. once for 0 yards. I mean, when you got A.J. Green, you got to ride him, especially when nothing else is working. And they haven't been able to do that, whether that's Dalton, whether that's the offensive coordinator. I don't know. I don't think that Ken Zampezi, the offensive coordinator, has a lot of confidence in himself. I don't think he's real sure of his own play calling. And when your offensive coordinator isn't real confident in himself, you're not going to see it on the field. So pick a spot, Dan. I mean, throw a dart and it's like, it's not that difficult to diagnose. Everybody's not doing well.
But it feels like the season's already over after two games.
Yeah.
Right?
Sure does, especially given the opponent the next time out. I mean, they had played the Ravens and the Texans offense. Joe Flacco, God love him, couldn't throw the ball 15 yards last week. And they managed to score 20 on the Bengals. This offense, Deshaun Watson played like a kid making his first NFL start. The only thing he can do well is run around, and they let him run around once, and that was enough. When they go to Green Bay and see that offense, I mean, their eyes are going to be spinning around their heads like a Bugs Bunny cartoon.
Do you feel like this is, no matter what happens here, Marvin Lewis and Andy Dalton are a package deal here, that you could see a change there next year?
I for the first time ever, and I said this in July, I get the sense that Mike Brown really is ready to part ways with Marvin if they don't achieve this year. And the kicker is, you don't really know what Mike's definition of achieve is. Is 8-8 good enough again for him, or is he like everybody else and you got to make the playoffs and win a game? That said, I do feel there's a little bit more heat on Marvin, and that's obvious given he doesn't have a contract. Now, I don't know about Dalton. I call him good Andy and bad Andy. He has stretches where he's really good, where he's on target, he's in rhythm, he moves the team. And he has stretches where he just disappears and makes bad throws like he did most of the time last night. And for 2 weeks, he's been bad Andy.
Should be fun, Paul. I can't wait to read what you write at Lambeau. That'll be great.
Yeah, you know, Dan, I'm kind of a veteran at this. I've been here a long time, and I went through the 90s, and this kind of looks like the 90s. And the best thing is, you know, I get paid. That's pretty good.
But, Paul, can't you
I'm not one of the 52,000 out there last night, having to pay to watch that nonsense.
You should just plagiarize yourself and just go back and bring back to some of those articles from the 90s and then just slap in different names.
In deepest, darkest hours, I've thought about this. It's only my great personal integrity as a journalist that prevents me from doing that.
Oh, thanks for joining us, Paul. Good to talk to you again.
Anytime, Dan.
All right. Paul Daugherty, Cincinnati Inquirer. One of these days we'll have Paul on and actually talk about something positive with the Cincinnati Bengals or Cincinnati sports scene.
The Dan Patrick Show, weekday mornings on Audience.